It's Fran in the lab, preparing for my zero-G flight, and one of the things that I've been taking into consideration is how I'm going to deal with the audio issues, because it's going to be really loud in the plane, and I hate lapel mics, and lapel mic really wouldn't work anyway, because it's loud in the plane. So I'm doing a little side project to make a mission comm system just for this trip. Now, I got a bunch of these headsets. These are vintage 60s, 70s era mission control headsets. Pretty cool. I got the ones that are setups that you just snap them onto the... they attach to eyeglasses. Like that. Yeah, how about that? That's cool. So yeah, these are perfect, and they come, this part here clips onto the flight suit, and they have a really funky plug on them. And like I said, I got a bunch of these headsets several years ago, and I was planning on making a, like a mission comm panel. And I even got the really hard to find connectors for these really out there plugs. But I think that for this particular project, I want to be sort of light and lean and mean, because I want to be able to run this headset, both the microphone and the earpiece, to my Zoom digital recorder, which I'll be wearing on me. I'll put this in my flight suit. And I just really want to make a conversion to patch this, the mic and the earpiece, into the Zoom, so I'll be able to hear from the Zoom and talk to the Zoom and actually record my audio autonomously without, you know, a second copy, just that I'll carry on me just for this trip. And so I've got, I'm really just going to slice and dice. I'm going to chop up the regular stereo cable, you know, chop that, splice it in to the headset, you know, make it nice and clean with some shrink tubing, and make a just nice converter. And I've got a, like I said, I have other headsets that I can like do the full thing with a thing. I've even got, like I said, I was really adamant about doing a real project. I even got the real flight controller push to talk hand things, with a little stretchy cord, and they come with a really funky kind of connector. This is a Tele connector. They look like quarter-inch jacks, but they're not. They've got a special kind of a locking shape, and they're shorter. These are made for special jacks. I think they're originally made for the telecoms, you know, like operators and stuff like that. But yeah, that's. But I have like ways of converting that, but. But yeah, so I got like all kinds of stuff to use these headsets, but for this one mission, I'm going to do mean and lean. So one of the things is that the actual earpieces, right, that came with them, they were sealed in these polypropylene bags, and I've done videos about this, but yeah, PVC, these plastics, when they can't outgas, and so the original earpiece tubing and everything, it is completely liquefied. It's like a chemical gummy bear. It's just all just turned to goo. So I got some modern stretchy tubing. Like I had to get a whole big box of it. It's exact right internal diameter for the connector on that. And I got some silicone earbuds that were actually made for hearing protection, for these hearing protection filters, but they had the right hole diameter, so I was able to force fit the tube into that. Yeah, and so that really nicely fits in the ear for the hearing end, and this end goes on the back of the comm, like that. So I think this will definitely work. So let's take a close look. All right, so yeah, this is it close up. It's got the clip to go on the glasses, and there's there's several different versions of these headsets that I've seen in vintage NASA footage. The flight controllers, a lot of them had ones that had the tube that just ended, that have like a little brass insert in it. This type with a little wind protector, I've seen pictures in the early Apollo days. On Apollo 11, Buzz Aldrin is using a headset very much like this one in photographs. Interesting, the for wind protection for blowing on it, it's got a sintered metal shield in there. It's some kind of compressed sintered metal. Don't know what it would be. Probably something non-corrosive. And if there's an arrow on one side, I guess that means you talk into that side. So on the back side, it's also sintered, but there's no arrow. So I guess that's just the back end. The whole shaft is reinforced. Can't really be bent. It's not like it's not like a gooseneck. It's definitely has a certain shape that it's molded to, and bending it doesn't change the shape. And that's the little serrated thing that the flexible ear hose goes into. It just feels like just a threaded something, and just the threads grab onto the inside of the tube, you know, like so. Grips pretty well. And like I said, the other side of that, those original earpieces are completely, these are completely liquefied, turned into a smelly goo. But yeah, fortunately these, they make these for noise suppressors, and it just fit perfectly. So yeah, so custom earpiece should work just fine. That's molded in there. Wow. I don't know. Is that potted? That feels potted. Yeah, that is definitely a one-way thing. Okay. This can't be taken apart that I can see. That seems like it's potted in there. Huh. Well, yeah. I guess this is not intended to come apart. So, we're gonna have to do this the old-fashioned way. The old-fashioned way. Ooh. Good. All right. It's got the reinforcing strings in there. Let's do that for strength. Alright, so that's shielded, so that shielded part, that's going to be the microphone. So that's the microphone output, and then we got three other wires here. I wonder if that's equalized. You think that would be equalized? I don't think so. It's possible. But we'll, if it is equalized, we're just going to use the high side. All right, cut and stripped the two jacks. Those are ready to go. I wasn't going to take this apart, but now I have to, because I really have to find out what wires are going to what. So, all right, I'm going to do this very carefully. Remove the top clip. Need a third hand for this. They're in tight. Yeah, this is some kind of high impact plastic. I really hope I can get this back together. I hope there's nothing. So I do have a few more of these just in case I can't get it back together. Oh, there's a threaded. It's nice. Spare no expense. Yeah. careful. Ooh, okay. Flip it over here. Wow. There's a lot more in here than I thought there was. Wow. Wow. Okay, I don't want to lose that nut. All right, so, feels like there's some pieces here that on the top, there's a little foam thing there, like a little dampener, and this thing here broke in half. This looks like a little sleeve that's meant to hold the earpiece in. I hope I can get that back in. FranLab is really not set up for microscopic examinations, but all right, so inside here, that is the earpiece. Looks like it, and it is it's a rubberized. Yeah, see there, it's like a rubberized tube. It's flexible. So there's some kind. There's definitely an element in there. You can see it in the top. And that's, I guess, sound dampened with this soft, cushy foam, which I hope is still working. Very, very thin, fine magnet wire. And clearly the white and the black are the earpiece. And the red and the shield are the microphone. And I do not see the yellow wire on this end. Yeah. So as I suspected, the red is the microphone. There's a yellow wire, but that's not used. So I guess the yellow wire is just superfluous. It must have come with the cable that they were using. But yeah. So we're only using these are the earpiece, and that is the microphone. So it makes it real easy. Just have to, that extra sponge in there is up against the earpiece, so I guess they're just trying to. These are pretty slick, these threaded tubes. This is one of those cases where I can either stay out of the shot or I can do it, but I can't do both because it's just too delicate. All right, let's see if it's still, yeah, okay, it still maneuvers. Right, seems to work. All right, that's all I have left behind is a tiny little piece of that little acrylic collar. Couldn't be helped. All right, but we got we have the wiring out. As you'd expect, they're Teflon, so gotta get the special trimmer. We got Teflon wire. The Teflon stripper is indispensable. There's just no other way to do it. So what I did is I sort of took the two splayed ends and kind of pushed them together to kind of intermesh them a little bit, and then I'm going to blob that and then I'm going to crush it. That way it'll be nice and flat when I actually get the whole package together. That'll come together very nicely. So I'm going to mark the microphone end with some red nitro nail polish. Right, so now I know that that's the microphone end. I'm just going to dry that. Okay, so before I totally seal this up, I'm going to test it. So I'm going to clip it to my glasses. Get the earphone in. Earphone. And I have a volume control here, so check, see if I get anything here. Check one. Oh, there's something. Oh, it's very, very weak. Check, check, check. Yeah, it's, and I can't hear myself, so yeah, it's very weak.
Okay, so I'm a little bit of a preamp. I got my Peach Fuzz being used as a preamp. I can notice that the cord makes a lot of rattling. I have that behind me. Okay, so, okay, much better. Alright, so, yes, this is the setup I got with the Peach Fuzz and check one. Just like they did on Apollo 13, Tom Hanks said that, you know, when they weren't doing the zero G, they had to, most of the shots were done in the studio, and they would sort of just squat down and go like this, and kind of pretend like they were floating around in zero G, and then go up and down, and like, for all of you on the good earth, I'll say, till next time, this is Fran, preparing for zero G with my comm system, some modifications required. But anyway, I want to thank everyone who has been chipping in to the GoFundMe on this one. We're just about, well, we're getting close to being funded, so we're definitely doing this. So thank you everyone who did the GoFundMe, and thank you to all of the patrons down there on the Patreon, making all these videos possible, including this one in zero G, because you can see I'm floating around. I'm Fran. I'll see you back here at the lab or up in orbit pretty soon. All systems go.
In the lab. That's where I work. In the lab. Go berserk. My lab, it's where I work. Watching. I'm Fran.